And welcome back to... Hello, people, and welcome back to Queerology, the study of all gay shit.
I don't know what he's up to, but welcome back to Queerology, the colored side of queer things. Once again, it is Micky.
And the Black Winds.
He's extra special today.
I know. He...
Anyway.
Today, we will be doing...
Why are you like this?
I don't know. The same thing we did last week.
Bitch and complain. No, last time we talked about mental health, dating apps, and disappointments.
Sounds like my afternoon.
If that also described your last relationship, I apologize. I couldn't do it. I'm sorry.
Oh,
I couldn't do
God.
It. I tried to do that with a straight face. So it wasn't going to work.
Fired.
But no. So for today, we are going to be talking about
that gay shit.
More of that gay shit. Division within the LGBT plus community as a whole.
And biphobia.
And biphobia and erasure.
I told tasty. You. I told you we was coming for it. You didn't believe me.
I'm not even going to test.
I know they didn't believe me. I felt like they were just like, mm-hmm. Yeah, they ain't say shit about that. Mm-hmm.
We're going to get to it eventually.
No, bitch, we coming. We coming for you. Anyhow. All right. Division is a type of thing with math, but that's not what we're talking about today.
I think last time we covered that gays don't... Nope. We're two gays that don't do math.
Math is hard.
Don't do meth either. That's just a general PSA. Sorry.
Drug bad.
Drug use in moderation fun. Methamphetamines are bad. Please don't do those.
I don't think we should... You know, who cares?
Who knows?
You're not going to listen to us. All right. Conform or die. The division between LGBT as a whole. The high school clique mentality. Now, I don't know if you think that you don't do this, but I promise you, I'm pretty sure that the fuck that you do. Now, who remembers high school?
I don't want to remember high school. That's 100% certain.
Oh, God.
I just realized how many years it's been. Oh, God.
Oh, my God, we're old.
Okay. We're not that old. We're not that old, but we're old.
Oh God, girl, 23 is like the new old.
It's not old. We just feel old because we're just tired all the time.
AKA old.
But what? Are we, like okay? So like everyone remembers high school. Those high school movies. If mm-hmm. you are choosing to not remember your own. Everybody had the cliques. You had the popular girls. Mm. Okay. We talked about gay icons last time. The movie yes. Mean Girls. All right. Ooh. You had the jocks, the preps, the cheerleaders, the football players. I don't know. I went to a different high school where you couldn't really see much of that. But you did have the, we called them the nerd herd and the band kids.
That's kind of
so cute. The nerd herd were like four dudes. And then you had the nerd herd and then the lady nerds. So it was like the top four, the top eight students really for our year. And they were like super duper smart. We all loved them. Nobody actually really got picked on TBH. But we still had football players, cheerleaders, all that stuff. You had the cliques, the people you hang out with. They defined your social experience in high school according to books, movies, and I guess in some places real life. I don't know. I didn't really
have
that.
That's actually a weird thing.
I didn't have that in my school. I was one of those in-between type people. I hung out with kind of everybody.
Me too.
I was social enough.
We are getting completely off topic. True or false? There is a lot of clique mentality within our community as a whole.
Yes, true.
It's... How do I put this? I feel like everyone chooses sides in a way. and they kind of hang out with people. Well, it's one thing to hang out with people that you're similar with. It's another thing to exclude other people because they're different.
That's where you get the click.
Yeah, and that it creates like a gigantic division between people. Like, if you ever notice, twinks hang out with other twinks. Bears typically hang out with other bears. Lipstick chicks. I don't know what lipstick chicks do. Is that even still a terminology?
They aggravate us because it's so beautiful and so unattainable. She said they no, it's like. Us. Do we even really call them that? I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know if we use that term still. That's a really outdated term. You had like lipstick, butch, stone butch, Bambi.
Pillow princess. I remember pillow princess. No, I like
that's not perfect. She would X-rated podcast, my friend. No, that's more of that's been replaced with Bambi, I think. Or no, Bambi's much older. Either way, it's like the type of girlfriend that like is not interested in reciprocating. I don't know if it's like they don't want to. Or it's like, you can ask, I guess. I don't know. I don't know about all that.
Lazy heifer.
I mean, some people just don't, like, some people just don't want to do it. And it's like, if you ask them and then they are going to say no, then they just using you for sex. So you also keep a lookout on that. But yeah, it's like, there are different types of groups in the LGBTQ+ community. And we tend to hang together. Yeah. And away from others because of safety in numbers.
But, like, I feel like that creates an issue because there's a lot of hate between different groups, though.
It is. Is it hate? Is it really hate?
I think it's hate.
I can see where you would feel like it's hate.
Well, okay. Well, tell me what you think about it. Because, personally, I feel like there's a lot of, like, hate towards it. Like, you kind of have to fit into a certain stigma, or you're just, like, you're ex.
Ostracized, yeah.
Yeah.
Like, it's like, I don't know, I'm trying to think of, like, the best example.
It's kind of like the thing from the last episode where we were talking about the whole hierarchy thing.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's so much...
Girl, bowls are moving. It's haunted. Okay.
The energy of the gays have said, stop spreading the tea. But I don't give a fuck.
Oh, God.
I'm the Black Wind and I will do what I please. Anyway. No, but I feel like it's an issue. Because, like...
It's...
I don't, like... How? Like, I'm trying to find the way to explain it.
We're going to have to drop some, like, old gay history on this.
Ooh.
For
you youngins.
I took, like, one semester of queer history, so, like, I'm an expert. Just kidding. God. But no, so it's, like, starting way back Stonewall time. It's also the 50th anniversary of Stonewall riots, so but y'all should look into that.
But you guys probably don't know anything about that.
Y'all don't know shit about Stonewall. Other than that stupid-ass movie, but we ain't even going to talk about that. But no, so...
Go ahead.
Starting with, I think it dates back to the gay rights movement when it started way back then, how it was really only gay men and lesbians and drag queens. Yeah. Gay men, lesbians, drag queens. And
there's a few trans people in there.
Yeah, trans, Marsha, Sylvia, and those are the real icons, first of all. But it's like the focus was put onto gay men for the gay rights movement, because then you had, of course, the AIDS epidemic and stuff like that. And this is just me paraphrasing it. I don't have all my sources on me. They can be looked up and cited later. Oh, but yeah. It's like starting with the gay rights movement, the riot at Stonewall. Remember, Pride was originally a riot.
Exactly.
Be gay. Do crimes.
Oh my God, yes.
But. And it. They gained the focus when the AIDS epidemic set in. And that left the other groups like lesbians, transsexual, any other identity was really much pushed to the background.
Really, though.
And there's a movie called Before Stonewall. It's a documentary of it.
I think I've seen that.
Yeah, and if you're a queer studies major, more often than not, it gets put onto the list of things you need to watch. And it's a really interesting movie. I do encourage people to watch it because it kind of shows how a lot of the things that you see the men fighting for was stuff that the lesbian groups were already fighting for.
Exactly.
But the gay men took over and they did that. So there's that hierarchy. It started with the men. It's like, okay, once the men get their rights, okay, then they'll help the women get their rights. And then it's like,
But the sad thing about that goes all the way down to the lives of women throughout history.
True, but that's a whole nother thing too. But then it's like, it's that, yes, I'm being oppressed. This is where it comes in. It's like that, yes, I'm being oppressed because I'm gay, but at least I'm not gay and a woman. Or at least I'm not gay and trans in some way. Or at least I'm not gay and this. And so it's that problem within the community where we want to step on each other be like, at least I'm not in this group.
And I think that's the issue with the whole trans hate right now. I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself.
It is vital. We can pull it up now.
Yeah, because I want, like, something else I wanted to discuss on, like, this show was about transphobia. But I'm not going to jump too far into that because there's
a whole
episode thing, within itself. But if you think about how things are going right now, once the gays got their, got our ability to marry and, like, more, you hear about, like, people being gay and it being okay a lot more now than you used to. But did you notice that once that happened, it was like there needs to be another group to hate then?
Yeah.
And then it became, like, the trans people.
It became because it's, like, it's very upsetting, but it's, like, still lesbians are only seen as a category on Pornhub. Like, people, but you're too pretty to be a lesbian. Bitch, I know.
Oh, God, don't even.
First of all, I'm too pretty.
Not bitch, I know.
It's, like, I'm gorgeous and a lesbian. Deal with it. Oh, God. But it's, like, with women, it's like they push off their very intimate relationships as being close friends or bosom buddies. That's my favorite term because I am buddies with your bosom.
I saw something like that earlier. I think it was about gal pals. They were like, oh my God, gal you're pals. Such good gal pals.
It's like, bitch, that was
and funny. She's like, this is my girlfriend. Oh my God, we're gal pals. We have a child. Oh my God.
Such close friendship. Such close friendship.
And they were roommates.
But, like, that's part of the issue, I think. It's, like, it's that, like, we haven't talked about the fetishization of the different communities, but I feel like lesbians especially get it very heavy-handedly because, like,
they've always had it bad.
Yeah, any natural female interaction, like, I can't count how many times I've had fuckboys come up and be like, that's hot. Like, you mind if I... No! We do mind.
I'm minding my business. Jesus.
I do mind. Go away. Like straight up, girls can't even be friends anymore because fuckboys want to be involved. Like...
Oh my God. Like, can we just cancel fuckboys, by the way? Like, an addendum to this entire conversation. Can we just banish them to the... just gone.
Give me an untraced mail. I can't say that. But it's like, it's that type of... Yeah, so it's like the gays, y'all got what y'all got. And then... It's like, okay, who's next? Who's easily identifiable and weird?
Exactly.
Drag queens, transgendered people. And it's like, I'm going to put that, I should have put this disclaimer out. It's like, I cannot speak from the point of view of a transgender person or from a transsexual person.
Me neither.
That is not my identity. It is only from what I have observed in my conversations with people of these identities and from what I read from online sources. Great. So, but with that, it's like, what is it? It's like that gaydar that people say they have. It's just, it's like, oh, I can always spot a person who's gay. Of course you can, Karen. It's called profiling. But it's called profiling and stereotypes. It's, yeah, that's why you have these cliques. Like, you have the people who are at the top that have no problem. They can breeze through the classes.
Oh, yeah.
Them's the gays. You have lesbians who have been fighting just as long, if not longer.
If not longer and harder.
The women were coming up with the ideas, but y'all were taking them.
Oh, God.
I ain't gonna lie.
We ain't even gonna go there.
We can't go there, because that's gonna start a whole nother problem.
Uh-huh. There are gonna be arguments in the comments. Y'all better behave.
This is a safe space, but everybody's in the firing range. Okay?
Let me catch somebody acting a mess.
But it's one of those, and so it's unfortunate that instead of this being a community of love, which we try to present ourselves as,
and that
we are using that to... It's a community of love unless you are...
Blank, 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 blank.
Fill in the blanks, pick a number.
Exactly. And that's what bothers me. It's just like, how is it that you get to pick and choose...
Who gets to be in our community.
Exactly. Because, like, there's a lot of hate against, like, trans people. Especially, like, right now.
Mm-hmm.
In the news, I have heard on multiple occasions, every time I turn around, it's something about some trans person has gone missing. Or some trans person has ended up dead in some ditch or something.
Black trans women. Any trans woman of color are... always in danger, because in the United States, it is legal to kill a trans person and claim that you were in fear because they were not who you expected. I think it was last year or the year before, several women on the East Coast were killed with random attacks, but it was, oh, we went home together. I found out they were a man. I found out that they had male genitalia, and I killed them. And it's like, that's what they told the courts, and those people got off.
And that makes sense. How?
It makes sense when you're not the ones being hated. And it's like, it's dangerous.
Exactly.
It's all these types of problems. So it's like, I worry about it a lot. So, like, I just put into Google... trans woman, and one of the first things that pops up is an article from BBC posted at 9:03 yesterday titled "Why Are Black Trans Women Being Killed in Dallas?" And it talks about not only the most recent one, and I don't know if I'm pronouncing her name correctly, but Chynal Lindsay, who was in Dallas.
Yeah, I had heard about that. One of my trans friends had posted it on Instagram. And I was just like, oh, my God. Again. Because it's not even just like... This isn't something that happens every once in a while. This is something that happens...
Every week.
Yeah, like, incredibly frequently.
And then the same article goes down to... It mentions other people as well. October of last year. I'm reading straight from the thing. It's like... In October of last year, the body of Brittany White, who was 29, was found in a parked car in the city with fatal gunshot wounds. It mentions Mulesha Booker, I hope I pronounced her first name correctly, who was not only filmed being beaten severely by other men, I'm believing, from her neighborhood. They also came back and killed her later. And it's like that type of just straight malicious hatred is what I don't understand within this community, this division of quite literally conform or die.
Exactly.
And it's like I worry about it all the time, just simply because I do have friends that are trans, but just as a human being.
Yeah.
Why is that the penalty for not strictly Like, you guys, like, I'm not gonna say you guys, because then I'm start getting mad. But it's like, people are all
not
like,
girl, you know what?
It's like, get, no, I'm gonna rage.
No, get mad. This is.
It's a severe, it's a aggravating issue because everyone's like, oh, yeah, we're all inclusive. We love this. You guys will support, you know, drag queens and stuff like that. And it's like, drag queens are all in good. Drag queens are fantastic. I wish I could do my makeup like that.
Same.
Like, but you'll stan a drag queen, but you won't help one of your friends on the street. It's like, in terms of, I don't have the statistic right now, but it's like, for transgender people, it's difficult. And when you're quite literally being hunted for sport, I don't know what to tell you. And it's always trans women of color.
You know.
And when it is, unfortunately, when it is white trans people who die, it is by their own hand. It's not, I have yet to see a trans woman of color kill themselves, which is also very upsetting to me.
That is a thing that happens, though. Trans people committing suicide, that is, there's a huge
there's an uptick in that as well.
Definitely. Because, and let's be honest, let's just put all the cards on the fucking table. Why would you
want why would you want to still be around when everyone is telling you not to be?
Exactly.
And it's like I've been in situations where it's like, not even just due to my sexuality, just due to different things where I've had depression and I've had that thought. I've been at that crossroad. And I'm like, everyone at school, everyone at home is telling me to kill myself. Like, I should. Like, I've been there. Like, I understand the immense amount of strength that it takes to take that final step. And I also understand and respect the immense amount of strength it takes to take that step back and to just reevaluate, center yourself and things like that. But it's, first of all, never okay to go and say something to anybody that could warrant that. And in this age where we are finally speaking up about our mental health and things like that, definitely not okay.
And finally, after all these years, trying to do something about bullying.
Exactly. Actually,
like,
trying.
Like, after all of these years, now all of a sudden everybody's just like, we need to stop doing bullying. You bitch should have stopped bullying.
My favorite lie that schools tell is that we have a zero tolerance against bullying. I had printed out comments of somebody bullying one of my very close friends. And the school still said, oh, you know, it's happening off of school property, so it doesn't count. Fuck that shit. I had physical evidence of this being done. And it resulted in, unfortunately, my friend at the time self-harming, because the school's not on your side. The school is essentially looking you in the face and's like, you don't matter enough for us to handle this situation. And it's like, this is what happens when you don't handle bullies early enough. They grow up, they quite literally turn into murderers. And with the way that our system, judicial systems are set up, oftentimes, because unfortunately our trans brothers and sisters are left out of all equations, the people who harm them and harm that community, harm our community,
get away.
Especially that branch of our community, get away with it because,
like, oh, like, whatever, you know?
It's like, oh, they were weird anyway. They're not weird. They're different.
They're people.
Actually, like, we're all weird, TBH. But it's like, they're just different. And it's like, yeah, last episode we were like laughing and joking, but it's like this right now, it has me so heated. I think because it's so recent and because it is constantly Black women, it is constantly Latinx women who are being
targeted
and killed and just brushed aside
like nothing happened. Oh, this person died.
And that's okay. why it's like, I mentioned intersectionality really quick last time. I'm going to mention it again. Intersectionality. With this, Black lives matter. Black trans lives matter. And it's like, for me, as a queer person of color, that is a stand that I think we all need to take.
Yes.
Because quite literally, it's one of those, we don't know who's going to be next.
And this goes back to what you said about people, like, everyone stepping on top of each other. Yeah. Remember back in the day when gay was literally just...
It encompassed everybody.
Not even just that. But remember when being gay was like that thing... Yeah, it was like the worst possible thing that you could be. And like everybody, you'd always hear about people getting gay bashed and like that type of stuff. Mm-hmm. Now the gay bashing has started to like go down. Now we have trans murder. Is there a term for trans murder? Like trans people getting messed up?
I mean, it's...
Is that still considered gay bashing? Because that has
to
be.
Not gay bashing.
Because that's considered, that's about it.
It's genuinely just hatred and insensitivity. Yeah, like, that's all it is, really.
Because, it's just, like, and there's so many gays out there. So many queer people. Because I'm not just talking about gay people. I'm talking about everybody.
There's enough of us that if we genuinely cared and took a stand, we could stop this. Like, that's really the long and short of it. There's enough of us that we could stop this if we genuinely put in the time.
But that's the thing is, a lot of them don't give a shit.
They don't.
And because I was listening to a friend talk the other day. I'm not going to say any names.
Yeah, we can't name
names. They were on Grindr, and they were just like, there's so many trans people on here. And I'm just like, well.
And?
I was just like, trust me, I get where you're coming from, but at the same time, there are we're supposed to be a family. We're supposed to be in this shit together. It's not all for one and one for all. Is
all for one, one for all.
Yeah.
That's the Three Musketeers, though. Whatever.
Right? But, like, it seems like everybody, let me not say everybody. It seems like a lot of people want to just pick and choose what's okay and what we can sweep under the rug.
And apparently, murder.
Yeah.
Swept under the rug.
I don't understand. And it goes back to the division. We're supposed to be a community. But there's nothing communal about this shit.
It's like what? Matthew Shepard, mate. May he rest in peace, was a gay boy who was killed, and they have entire foundations made to him. And that was just one. But it's like, it's because I'm also not trying to start crying either, because that's just how my emotions get me. But it's like, if we took the time to count each and every single one, not even from last year and all together, but just to start from the beginning of this year. Mm-hmm. And then on top of that, try and factor in the ones that aren't even reported because enough people don't care.
That part.
It's like, we're worried about, like, and rightly so, worried about school shootings and gun laws. But let's also look at people who are just literally being hunted like wildlife.
But, like, I feel like, I hate to throw the government under the bus. I don't really fuck with the government like that. But I feel like the government...
When have they ever been on our side?
I ain't even
gonna go there. We are two people of color.
I ain't even gonna go there.
I'm an immigrant.
I ain't even gonna go there.
All right.
I ain't even gonna go there. Shit. All right. But, like, it's just, like, I feel like nobody cares. And that's where the problem starts. You have to care before you can do anything. You have to care before you can do, before something can be done about an issue.
It's a lot of the better them, not me.
Eggs.
Yeah. Better them than me. Thank you.
Better them than me. Like, is that...
I said better them, not me. Y'all know what I'm trying to say.
We know what you say. You emotional.
It's like, I'm... I'd rather that this terrible thing happens to this group of people than it happens to my group of people.
And you know what we call that? Selfish. It's selfish. And it's terrible. Is that's... There's no other way to put it. It's selfish and terrible.
And it's just, it's something that needs to be stopped. So it's like that segues itself to, I guess, like what time? You're saying time.
We're running out of time.
45. We're 45 minutes.
Lord. Well, shit.
We can continue this conversation another day because we done ran out of time. Ranting and raving.
Right, ranting and raving. Emotions were high this episode. Damn. In conclusion, I think to fix this issue, we need to work.
Get rid of the
conform or die mentality.
We have to, because people are literally dying.
Dying.
Not even by their, like, not even, like, as... What is it? It's like people are dying because they don't fit a stereotype that's being perpetuated. And because they don't fit that stereotype, people don't care enough to help them.
Exactly.
Okay.
Well, let us wrap this episode up before we run completely out of time. Thank you for watching Queerology. I have been your host, the Black Wind.
Thank you for tuning in. I am Micky.
And
I'm tired.
Cut! And I'm tired. Cut!